Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for sticking around. And now we're wrapping up. We're on the last five songs of this series. I'm definitely enjoying it. Let me know in the comments below or text me what you want to see more of. Like, after I finish the series, where do you guys want me to go? What kind of stuff do you want me to break down and analyze and talk about? I'm definitely enjoying it. Finally Free was a lot of fun. It was definitely a really cool song. There's a lot of cool songs on here, actually. I enjoyed it a lot more than I expected. I'm not going to lie. I thought it was... The music's actually really great. The voices are incredible. Today we're doing Perfect Harmony, so I'm looking forward to hearing this one. So you guys, I think Finally Free and Perfect Harmony were two of the ones that you had requested the most. But we're going to continue going on through all of them, so I'm looking forward to the rest of the series. Like I said, definitely comment and let me know what you want to see more of. My name is Jacob Restituto. If you are new here, this is the first video you're seeing. My name is Jacob Restituto. I'm a musician myself, so if you want to check out my music, it's Jacob Restituto. Wherever you listen. And if you are a musician, I highly recommend clicking the link in my bio. If you want to release music, check out DistroKid, personally who I use, and you can save 7% on your first year. But they're great. You can put your music on Apple Music, Spotify, Pandora, all the different platforms. And they're the first ones to get your music on TikTok, which is actually really cool. But definitely use them. Highly recommend it. You can save 7% in the description. This is Perfect Harmony. Nice. I'm liking this. Wow, so I want to rehear that. So, very different than what I expected. It had this very clean acoustic feel, stereo acoustic guitars, one on the right ear, one on the left ear. Nice vibrato in Charlie's voice. I really like this, actually. This is really, it's different. It's very different from what bass coming in right in the beginning. Bittersweet love story about a girl. Shook me to the core. He's got a great vibrato. I feel like he's doing that push out vibrato kind of vibrato, which like is a distinct. I feel like distinct is something I personally do and I notice in myself. It's like shook me to the core, and you're like emphasizing the vibrato kind of to emphasize the emotion in it. So I find that really cool. I think it's working really well. I like the production on this. I really like the acoustic guitars. It has this really nice. I don't know, to some degree, almost, not eerie, but like this, what's the word I'm looking for? It like this reflective kind of like almost like maybe a sad part in a movie kind of feel. Voice like an angel, never heard before. Well, that was interesting, that like double kind of cymbal swell came in like twice. Never heard before. I like those drums. Madison's voice came in really nice here. Interesting mono guitar. Mono electric guitar right in the center of the mix, giving a kind of different feel to this than the two acoustics in the left and right. Nice layering. I like how they're starting to introduce like more modern instruments. We have the acoustic guitars, we have the electric guitars. Those instruments have been around for a long time. Now we're starting to introduce that hi-hat, and instead of it being like a regular kit hi-hat, like a hi-hat from a regular acoustic kit, now we have more of what I would call a like hip-hop style electronic hi-hat, kind of mixing the two genres. Nice, going to the minor there. I think you would expect it to go to the one, but it goes to the minor six. You and me together is more than chemistry. Nice. I hold your music here inside my hands. We say Nice. I like how they come in with that hi-hat, and this drum pattern is really nice. The voices sound really, really good. They blend, Madison and Charlie's voice go really, really well together. They blend really well. The different timbres of voice just fit really well. So it's interesting how they're meshing their harmonies and same melody at the same time. Like, they're harmonizing, but also they're landing on the same notes. We would call that cross voicing. Sometimes, like, when, so if you're normally singing up here and he's singing down here, and then they kind of flip, that's called cross voicing. And they're kind of going back and forth and hitting the same note and going back. It's interesting. It's kind of cool. Right there. That double cymbal is very interesting. I feel like it comes in early and then they have to like extend it out. That's why it's a double harm. The double. Chord progression sounds like it's going 1-4-1-5, I believe. Which is, and I think the first time it was 6-4-1-5. Kind of reminds me of like early 2000s kind of pop. Mid 2000s pop, like 2005. Charlie can hit some high notes full voice. It's pretty impressive. Oh, nice echo at the end. Oh, you hear that little fret vibe? Listen to that. That's actually from the guitar. It's from the fret vibrating on the strings. All right, let's go into the next version. I hope you guys are enjoying it. Let me know in the comments if you are enjoying the series. Or, honestly, be honest with me. Be honest. I love your honesty. So if you think it could be done better, let me know in the comments below. That being said, also as a reminder, if you are a musician, I highly recommend checking out DistroKid. Save 7%. You keep 100% of your royalties. Really great company, personally, who I use. So, and if you want to check out my music, Jacob Restituto, wherever you listen. Let's see what we got. Oh, see, this is cool. 5, 6, 7. I like how it's kind of starting with this different version. 7, 8. How you can hear the squeaking of the shoes. I was just walking in my house yesterday, and I moved really quickly and did a squeak. I was like, wow, I feel like I'm in the gym, you know, playing basketball in the gyms again, man. It's funny. I like how apparent the drums are on this one. Kind of like ASMR with all the feet moving. Really big bass going on. Step into my world. Bittersweet love story by. Wow, way more echo in here. Bittersweet love story about a girl. So cool set change. To the core. Voice like an angel never heard before. Here in front. Dude, the way her voice comes in is really, really killer. The way, like, she kind of almost slides into the note, which gives this extra kind of oomph to it. It's a lot of echo, though. So what I personally would have done in the recording of this is with the echo, I think it's just a little much. I liked how the other version, like if I could just go back to like where she comes in, maybe or somewhere.
bit.
It's a little clearer on her voice. You could hear a little. I like, actually, so I like in the Netflix version how it's a little bit more apparent, her voice. There's not as much going on. You could really hear her voice, but I like that there's less echo in the soundtrack. Because what I would have done here, personally, is something called ducking. What ducking is when you... So, it's actually... Like, if I say duck, you duck, you go down. So, what's happening when you do ducking with echo or reverb or anything like that, what happens is... So, if a regular echo is going to go... If I say, hey, it'll be, hey, 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 hey. But now, if I'm saying a sentence, like, hey, hey... if I say something like, hey, what's up? It'll be like, hey, what's up? Hey, what's up? Hey, what's up? You know, as I'm speaking. So, it starts to go on top. If I'm saying a sentence or keep speaking... The echo keeps going on top of what I'm already saying. What ducking does is it actually lowers volume to a desired amount. You could choose how much or how fast it goes into the duck. And depending on how fast you go, depending on how much you go, what it does is it creates this it quiets it down until it makes it go down like you're ducking, like, you know, duck, duck, goose kind of thing, ducking down. And then as soon as you stop speaking and it crashes, it goes through that threshold, then it goes up. So, for example, if I'm speaking, the echo is really low, speaking, I stop, echo comes back up because it passes the threshold. It says, hey, while there's some sound coming up above this threshold, I don't want you to come in. But as soon as the sound goes under this threshold, then boom, echo comes back in. So it creates this cool, it creates a little more clarity, if that makes sense. Let me know if you guys understood that. So, like, right there, it would have probably not said he goes. It probably would have just said goes because it would have ducked. But when he goes, I know he doesn't leave. The truth is finally breaking through. Harmonies are really cool. So that's interesting. It's like a hey going on too. That's new. And the upbeat, the syncopated eighth note beat. No, it's on the downbeat. Nice. I like the strumming and acoustics.
Wow, we nailed that. Thanks, partner.
Yeah.
Very cool. All right, well, hope you guys enjoyed that. Let me know in the comments below what you enjoyed, what you thought could be better. I definitely want to make this channel as enjoyable as possible, so I would love to know your feedback. That being said, if you're a musician, definitely check out JitsTrKid. If you want to check out my music, I'll put this links in the description. It's Jacob Prostituta, wherever you listen, or at the end of this video, you could take a listen to one of my 70 or 80 songs that I have out there. Or you could join me on the live streams where I make music on live stream here on YouTube. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great rest of today. God bless. Peace out, and enjoy your day. I know I shouldn't, but I still want your approval.